Hello everybody, and welcome to episode 11 of the Minecraft Hardcore. I don't really have much time this week, so basically today all I did was I just upgraded part of the basement. Pretty much a lot of the houses and stuff and like random farms I've been neglecting, I decided to go back and build in the same sort of style that I had already. So right here, I believe I'm adding a carrot farm, and I'm getting sort of just the dimensions all set up for like the basic water bucket and then kind of carrot farm around it. So let's see what's happened. Let's see, this week I have just kind of chilled. I mean, I've been playing a lot of Minecraft on the one new realm we have, which is a lot of fun. I hope we don't get burnt out from that, but we've been playing like a shit ton, so I'm not surprised if we do. But my birthday is coming up soon. That's pretty cool. Today's the 26th. It is coming up on the 28th. Never mind. I thought I heard someone enter my door. But yeah, basically all I'm doing is just making everything look like it fits where it's supposed to be. Pretty much, I mean, it's just adding everything, like adding wood, adding like just making it seem like it's part of the underground part, like adding lanterns, making it seem like it's the kind of shop aesthetic that I'm kind of trying to go for. And for the tree farm, I decided to do something a little different because I thought it just kind of looked good, and I put leaves on the side, and in the end it actually turned out really cool. I needed a ton of leaves though, so it's like that was a little issue. And there, I just got recently attacked by like a zombie that scared the crap out of me, so he went around and made sure everything was 7. So now I'm setting up a melon farm because it's just another one of those things I didn't have, and it was kind of annoying. And that was also annoying because I was one block away getting that water. So now I'm just going around cutting trees, trying to just basically finish up all the farms. And there's the melons. Bam, 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 bam. They're all good. And just finishing up the little thing. Next thing I plan to do is I'm going to go to the end and get some more shulker boxes along with more sheep, because it's just something I didn't have. Because it was just one of those things, is like, you know what, if I get a shit ton of them, I'll never have to worry about it again. And that was one of those things that, oh, this is funny. This zombie spawned in a freaking 1x2 area, and it frustrated me for so long, because I could just hear him for so long. It was just so annoying. So here I am, made it to the end, just kind of cruising around. Just searching and searching and searching and searching. I think I find 3 or 4 end city or end things. I know I get a couple of elytras. I think I have, I want to say I got 2 more, so I have 3 now. Yeah, these end things are annoying. Like, they're definitely fun, but they take a lot of effort and concentration to get them. Because, like, you have to make sure everything's cleared, and it's like, if you don't levitate, you gotta make sure you don't levitate. Oh, I also got a ton of purple glass, but I feel like I might use it later. But, that wasn't really too important. Let's see, I'm gonna try to think what I'm doing, how I'm chilling. Oh, yeah, so I made, I guess, more project, update on just, like, what I'm doing school-wise. So, last couple weeks, I made, a balloons tower defense, exact replica. Not exact replica, like I got every single sort of mechanic you want in there. It's like there's the chickens can spawn, there's like waves, you get custom waves you can make, towers can like have priority so you can see which tower you want to look at. It's pretty much the exact thing with balloons tower defense. The only thing I don't think I added was the giant blimps, but honestly that just is just a bigger chicken with health. So it's like at the end of the day, I was pretty much had everything, so I was pretty proud of that. And I don't really know what I'm working on now. I got like a bunch of work I can work on, but like for personal project, I haven't really I haven't really thought of anything. So I'll be thinking of stuff. I might have a. My first thought I've thought of so far is a game where you control two cubes that move in the same direction and you have to get them to touch each other. But other than that, that was my first thing that I was kind of mocking up. But other than that, I haven't really thought of anything. So here I find two end cities super close to each other, which is really nice. One of them had a ship, the other one did not, so you know, can't complain, but cranking out a ton of shulkers. Like right here I have two more just in my inventory, and I know in the ender chest I had at least like 20 shells, so I nearly died to a freaking enderman. So I just fly around and heal up for a bit. That was close. I was at 3.5. I think I just honestly just left after that. I was just kind of done. This is me not understanding how negative and positive coordinates work and take forever to get back home. But at the end, I get home. So yeah, you got that crouch. This is the village I'm trying to find. The desert one. I had a village that I have, and I just gave up and found it the quickest way. Like, for all the sand and stuff, is just to fly back and forth, because I couldn't. The portal's in, like, such a terrible location. So I end the video by dyeing all the shulkers in rainbow colors, just because it's good. And I've got enough shulkers to fill the top row of ender chest, so like 9 plus like 40 shulker things, so I can make like 29 shulkers. And yeah, next video I will be doing an Amazon warehouse for all my storage. Thank you for watching.